Good evening. Welcome to St. John's, York Mills, this Thursday of Holy Week, known as Maundy Thursday. If you are visiting, thank you for joining us as we join Jesus on the eve of his arrest and crucifixion. My name is Richard. Everything you need for the service will be on the slides. On the night before his arrest and crucifixion, Jesus shared a meal with his followers. He offered the bread as his body and the wine as his blood. He instructed his followers to observe this rite after his death and resurrection. In response, we celebrate the Eucharist, also known as communion. Jesus then did another remarkable thing. He rose from the table, took a towel and a basin with water, and he washed his followers' feet, an act of extreme humility and love. By washing their feet, he set an example to do to others as he has done to us. Finally, Jesus gave his followers a new commandment, to love one another. These three elements, Eucharist, foot washing, and the commandment to love, are the focus of our service this evening.
Be
Our first element is the Eucharist. Please listen as God's word is read. And after this, Christine, our new youth faith facilitator, will help us to understand the essence of the Eucharist.
A reading from Matthew 26, verse 26 to 29. Now as they were eating, Jesus took bread, and after blessing it, broke it and gave it to the disciples, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." And he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. For this is the blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will not drink again of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom." The word of the Lord.
The Eucharist is a gift from Jesus himself. It is a simple meal, a familiar symbol, and seemingly ordinary. Yet it is capable of reminding us of the most important things in life: the person of Jesus, his sacrifice on the cross, and his risen life and presence with us today. That last meal he has before he dies is communion, his disciples coming together and giving thanks. In the Eucharist, Christ gives simple elements, and by his words, he transforms them. We don't have to understand the Eucharist fully in order to participate. We just have to receive. Jesus himself invites us to remember his body and blood. It is an invitation and gift. He alone makes it possible for us to have communion with him. And it is a free gift, always available to us. In the bread and the wine that we eat and drink, we somehow participate in Christ's life. He is the living water, and all things have their being in him. He is the one who went through death so that we can live. His body was for our salvation. Communion is about becoming one, in some small way, with Jesus himself. The same power that raised Christ from the dead transforms us and the Eucharist to reflect the truth and beauty and power of God. Jesus died so that our relationship with himself and the Father could be mended, and while on the cross, Christ gave himself for us. But before he died and paid the price for our sins, in the Eucharist, Christ gave himself to us. The amazing grace of God is that God so loved the world before he had even saved it. Christ's blood was the power of the life giver, and when he died, he gave all of himself. He gave all of his life to save all of ours. The power that created this world and breathes life into our nostrils resurrected the body of Jesus and made his heart beat and blood flow once again so that nothing, not even death, could keep us from him forever.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Behold the Lamb who made Savior Jesus Christ taught for you. Eat and remember the wounds that heal, the death that brings us life, paid the price to make us one. So we share in this bread.
Our second element is the foot washing, this remarkable and surprising act of Jesus after the meal with his closest followers. Please listen to the story as scripture is read. And after this, Allison, our children's faith facilitator, will give us an understanding of the foot washing and why Jesus commands us to do likewise.
A reading from the Gospel according to John. During supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going back to God, rose from supper. He laid aside his outer garments and, taking a towel, tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was wrapped around him. When he had washed their feet and put on his outer garments and resumed his place, he said to them, "Do you understand what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for so I am. If I then, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have given you an example that you also should do just as I have done to you." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Lord Jesus. You take on the work of a servant, and you show the object of your love, your deep and abiding care for them, by humbling yourself. You take the towel and gird yourself with it, pouring the water into a basin. You gently and carefully wash away the stains of the world. And when our sweet Lord comes to us, he girds himself with the towel and pours water into the basin and begins to wash our feet. We must let him, despite his great and glorious kingship. Allow our tender Jesus to care for you, and so you too will care for others.
Light flood my being.
Our third element for Maundy Thursday is Jesus' command to love. Please listen as God's word is read.
A reading from the Gospel according to John. A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also are to love one another. By this, all people will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
My family enjoys being out of doors, especially in the woods, so camping has been a regular part of our diet, especially when Hampton and Gillian were young. There were times when we would car camp, and there were other times when we would backpack. On one backpacking trip, my daughter Gillian and I were at a high peak, actually had just come off the high area, and were in a plateau. And we found ourselves caught, and caught is the appropriate word, in a microburst. Do you know what a microburst is? It's a weather phenomenon that you don't want to experience firsthand. It is a concentrated upheaval of the heavens, tornado force winds, hail, the temperature drops precipitously, instantly, and you find yourself hanging on for dear life. All I could do was to put my daughter Gillian against a tree, wrap my arms around her in the tree, and pray, truly pray. And I was afraid. I did not know if we would survive this. The temperature became extreme in a hurry. The rain, the hail, things were gushing down, a torrent. I was afraid and experiencing love at the same time, love as I clinged to my daughter. Jesus gives us a new command. We're told it's a new command to love one another. What is Jesus doing here? We hear this word love a lot. We know we are to love. In fact, this has been of the essence since the beginning of time. God created in love, and we know the first and greatest command is to love the Lord our God with all that we are. The second is like unto it, to love our neighbor as ourself. I believe that we best do this as we combine those elements of fear and love. Because knowing God's glory, how awesome God is, that in God's presence, we are to fall down. We are to be aware of God's glory and realize how small we are in God's presence. Yet that's not the only emotion there, because we become aware of God's love. And what do we see in the other two elements for this Maundy Thursday? First, the Eucharist, where Jesus gave himself to us and continually does so, and Jesus gave all of himself on our behalf, stood in your place and mine. We are connected, united to the risen Jesus Christ by the Holy Spirit. And we renew this each time we celebrate at the altar, celebrate Eucharist, which means thanksgiving. There is much mystery in this. If you want less mystery, just receive it on its face. Jesus saying, "This is my body, this is my blood shed for you." And look to the second element, which is this business of foot washing. Jesus is God, God giving up all of God's prerogative, becoming one of us, fully God, fully human, so God could identify with us And we see great power in humility as Jesus stoops and washes his followers' feet, an act of service. And how is this significant in the command? Jesus says, "A new command I give you, to love one another as I have loved you. Just as I love you, love one another." And when we do this, people become aware of Jesus. That is how we cooperate with the Holy Spirit to break into people's lives, to go through the cracks when they appear, to warm hearts, to save lives, to give new life. We're to love just as Jesus loved us, and that is that picture of love, the Eucharist and the foot washing. It doesn't necessarily mean that we're going to die for others, but it does mean to lay down our lives. It is to say, "Jesus, you are God, and because of you, I live. I have new, unending life. Nothing can separate me from you and your love, not even physical death. And one day, it'll all be made right when you return, and we will behold your glory, beholding you face to face." So we can ask, beg Jesus to give us that heart, his heart by the Holy Spirit, that loves is an act of service, giving of ourselves to others, putting others before self, sacrificing, sacrificial love, humility. And remember, humility is not thinking less of ourselves, as in, "Oh, I'm nobody." It just means we think of ourselves less often. We spend more time looking to Jesus and what he has done. May we love one another as he has loved us. Amen.
Thank you.
Our service concludes with what's known as the stripping of the altar and the removal of the ornaments of this space known as the chancel, which signifies Jesus being stripped of everything for you and for me, having taken on all of our wrongs. He willingly allowed himself to be arrested, to go through a sham trial, and then to be executed unjustly, the greatest injustice of all time. So we remove all the ornaments of the space and are mindful that Jesus was left alone. We then conclude in the darkness with a brief word, which also signifies Jesus' closest followers betraying him in his greatest hour of need, and our betrayal, because our rejection of God, of Jesus, is betrayal. So we reflect on Jesus' powerful love, exercising humility, all for you and for me, to save us, to set us free, and give us new life.
Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." And taking with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is very sorrowful, even to death. Remain here and watch with me." And going a little further, he fell on his face and prayed, saying, "My Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will." And he came to the disciples and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter, "So, could you not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." Again, for the second time, he went away and prayed, "My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done." And again he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So leaving them again, he went away and prayed for the third time, saying the same words again. Then he came to the disciples and said to them, "Sleep and take your rest later on. See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand."
A song in itself is not what you have written.
search much deeper within. Through the way things appear, you're looking into my heart. I'm coming back to the heart of worship, and it's all about you. Sorry, Lord, for the thing I've made it, when it's all about you, all about you, Jesus. King of endless world, no one could express how much you
Christ was obedient unto death. Go in his peace.